Can cryptocurrency be traced? So one of the many questions we get asked here at Easy Crypto is, can my cryptocurrency transactions be traced? There are many, many kind of misinformations floating around the internet, and a lot of people presume that Bitcoin is this pseudo-anonymous currency that kind of floats around and can be used for drugs and dodgy dealings and horrible things. And of course, back in the day, 8-9 years ago, there were of course people that used it for those purposes because the ecosystem itself was a little bit less developed than it is now. And everyone thinks that because you don't have a name with Josh and Josh's Bitcoin wallet connected, that there isn't a way to track those type of transactions. So everyone who's dealing in Bitcoin is totally anonymous and you can get away with everything. Well, I'm here to kind of bust that bubble. Unfortunately, that is not true. It has never really been true. And actually, we've seen a lot of instances historically of people getting busted because they're using Bitcoin. So quick facts for you watching this video. Once I have, say, Bitcoin and I send it to another wallet address if I wanted to move those coins around, the blockchain, the kind of posh spreadsheet that underpins Bitcoin and all the other cryptos, effectively tracks every single transaction in that journey. So if I've moved my coins from here to here to here, you'll be able to follow that transaction. So whatever I do with any of my coins within the ecosystem of crypto is all entirely trackable on a public blockchain like Bitcoin. There are, of course, some cryptocurrencies which have specifically been designed for anonymous transactions. So even though Bitcoin itself is a public ledger, there are some that have private features, and there are some in which effectively delete the previous transaction every time a new transaction is created. Now, there's a range of reasons why that's the case, and there's always going to be some people that want to hide the identity in this type of environment. And in general, there's many companies out there today that offer forms of anonymous payment. You know, there's traditional companies, as it were, that use pounds and pence or dollars and euros, who will put your payment through as something else on your bank, specifically to avoid something coming up on record as what it is. So this happens from a range of different websites, from adult entertainment to different ecosystems where people have arguably legitimate reasons to keep their identity anonymous. So I'm not here to kind of judge the morality of the reasons behind people wanting to or not wanting to do something. The technology for being completely anonymous within crypto does exist. How many times have we had a builder or an electrician or, you know, insert kind of person of choice want a cash payment rather than doing things through the books? There's many reasons why people would do that. And again, it's not always disingenuous, but it's a case of trying to use the systems that we have in new ways. So there's always going to be people that try to do things anonymously. There's always people who are perfectly happy to be above board and transparent. And the technology that is the medium, whether it be cash in an envelope or whether it be an anonymous cryptocurrency, just changes as technology does. But fundamentally, you shouldn't ever be scared or worried about this space in, oh, crypto's dodgy, it's anonymous, it can be used for bad things. That's a very, very out of date kind of thought process. Many of the big banks, governments, and international institutions now recognize this form of asset class. And in order to kind of not enter this space because of some negative misconceptions would be a really silly thing to do. You know, if we were to say money is bad because someone once used it to buy drugs, that would be a stupid thing. It doesn't make cash intrinsically bad. People will, of course, always have negative motivations for whatever it is in life, irrespective of the medium of exchange. Thanks for watching, everyone. I've been Josh from Easy Crypto Hunter, and I hope you've answered some of your questions here on the channel. If you want to get some more information about any other crypto topic that might be burning in your mind, take a little look around. Give us a like and a subscribe. Help spread the message of crypto education for everyone. And we look forward to seeing you in the next video.